In this video, we will see about Eclat algorithm, which is used to extract frequent IDs. In Eclat algorithm, vertical TID list database, this is horizontal transaction database in which transaction ID and list of items are present. This database is transformed into vertical TID list database, where an item has list of transactions which contains that item. For example, consider an item A. It has a list 1345, which means that transaction 1345 contains item A. So this vertical TID list database is used in Eclat algorithm to extract all the frequent item sets. So here let us see how to calculate support of an item set using vertical TID list database. We can calculate support of an item set of length k by intersecting the TID list of any two of its k minus 1 length subsets. Let us see, support of an item set A is equal to the TID list of A, as TID list of A contains 4 transactions. The support of an item set A is 4/6. And if you want to calculate support of an item set AC, we have to intersect TID list of A and TID list of C. By intersecting, we obtain the transactions 1, 3, 4, 5. So the support of an item set AC is 4/6. If you want to calculate support of an item set ADT, as the item set is of length 3, we need to take TID list of its 2 length subsets. So here we have considered TID list of AD and TID list of AT. So actually these are intermediate TID lists, and if these are available, we can directly intersect these TID lists to obtain the support of an item set ADT. We can obtain the intermediate TID list of AD by intersecting TID list of A and TID list of D. In the same way, we can obtain TID list of AT. By intersecting these TID lists, we obtain only one transaction after intersection, that is 5. So support of an item set ADT is 1/6. If n is the number of item sets, then the total possible number of item sets are 2^n. So in Lattice, 2^n nodes are required to store all the possible item sets. And as we have 5 items, in this power set Lattice, we have 32 nodes which stores all the possible item sets. As we have all the item sets in the power lattice, and we know how to calculate support of an item set using vertical TID list, we can directly traverse the lattice and we can check whether the particular node is frequent or not. All this can be done only if we have enough memory to store power lattice and all the intermediate TID lists required. But what if we don't have enough main memory to store entire power lattice and all the intermediate TID lists? Then we would like to partition the power lattice so that those partitions are stored in main memory and all the frequent item sets can be extracted. To partition the power lattice, we use equivalence classes. Equivalence classes is nothing but partitions of equivalence relation. A relation is equivalence only if it is reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. So here we consider prefix relation between two item sets. That is, two item sets are related only if they have common k-length prefix. Let x, y be two item sets. If k-length prefix of x and k-length prefix of y is same, then x and y are said to be related. Let us consider item sets A and AC. These two item sets are having common prefix of length 1. And we can tell prefix relation to be reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. So this relation is an equivalence relation. As we have equivalence relation, we can partition the lattice. Initially, we are considering prefix of length 1, and here equivalence class A contains all the item sets with common prefix A, prefix length 1, and that prefix is A. For class C contains all the item sets with common prefix C. Similarly for D, T and W. If we consider this pictorially, here this is the class W, this is class T, this is class T, C and A. These partitions are called sublattice and we process these partitions in reverse lexicographic order to guarantee that all the subsets information is present before pruning. For example, consider this class A, this sublattice. If we want to check whether item set ACW is frequent or not, we need to make sure that all its subsets are frequent or not. But here, we doesn't know whether subset CW is frequent or not. Until we check whether CW is frequent or not, we cannot prune this item set ACW. So, if we traverse in reverse lexicographic order, all the subsets information is available before pruning. So, we can store a sublattice in main memory and we can check all the item sets, whether all the item sets of that sublattice is frequent or not. Then replace that sublattice with another sublattice and in same way until we extract all the frequent item sets. Here, for that, when we have a sublattice, to calculate the item set support, we need to intersect the TID lists, and here we are seeing that if we want to calculate support of an item set ACT, we are intersecting TID lists of AC and AT. These are the intermediate TID lists that are stored in main memory, and this is how we calculate support of an item set ACT by intersecting. And if we want to calculate support of an item set ACD TW, we intersect the intermediate TID list and we obtain the support value. So till now we have seen how to split the lattice into sublattice and how to calculate support using vertical TID list database. But what if memory is not enough to store even the sublattice? Suppose that class A is large enough that it is not fitting in main memory, then we need to split the class A partition again. So we partition the lattice until the partition fits into main memory, until the sublattice fit in main memory. So here, if class A doesn't fit in main memory, then we partition the class A by using prefix length 2. That is, as we have obtained class A by using prefix length 1, if we want to split class A itself, then we use prefix length 2. So here the new equivalence classes that we have obtained is AC, AD, AT, AW. Where AC class has list of item sets with common prefix AC. AD class has list of item sets with common prefix AD. Similarly for AT and AW. So in this way, we partition the lattice until it fits in main memory, and all the required TID lists are fit in main memory. So once we fit the partition in main memory, there are different strategies to parse that class and extract frequent item sets. If the bottom up approach is that we start with item set A and we reach item set ACDTW, and top down approach is that we start with an item set ACDTW and we reach item set A. So there are different strategies to extract, to traverse the sublattice and extract the frequent item sets. This is what ECLAT algorithm, which is scalable and used to extract frequent item sets. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned something.